奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of Jesus, I bear testimony for the word.
各位弟兄姐妹，大家晚上平安。
Peace be upon all our brothers and sisters this evening.
晚上跟大家以这个题目来做彼此的勉励。
Today I'd like to use this topic for mutual encouragement.
听命胜于献祭。
That to obey is better than sacrifice.
这句话我们都很熟悉。
We are most familiar with this phrase.
因为我们知道。他的故事是发生在当时扫罗还做王的时候。
Because the story happened or occurred during the time when Saul was still king.
那当时候神就接着这个撒母耳去跟他讲，要他毁灭这个亚玛利人。
And God through Samuel, prophet Samuel, actually wanted Saul to annihilate the Amalekites.
那为什么特别要去毁灭或毁掉整个亚玛利亚人呢？
What was the purpose to annihilate this whole group of people?
因为亚玛利人他们在以色列人他们出埃及的路途呢，在背后暗杀他们或者袭击他们。
Because the Amalekites were actually killing off the stragglers for the people of Israel when they left Egypt.
所以神当时就讲说，他们必定要跟亚玛利人作战到底，或打到底了。
So God says that they need to remove these people of the Amalekites.
那现在就有这个机会了。
So now this was the opportunity given to Saul.
所以这个是个以色列族群里面的一个重大的一个使命。
So this became a very important instruction.For the people of Israel.
那如果你当时被卷选去做这项工作，你是当时的一个重大的一个英雄啊。
And so therefore you would be considered a hero, a big hero in this case if you have been selected to be part of this exercise.
那当他们已经出埃及进迦南地大概有400年的时间了。
And they have already entered Canaan, the land of Canaan, for about 400 years after they left Egypt.
但是你看，当中400年没有一个人被选中。
And during these 400 years, no one was chosen for this task.
可是现在竟然扫罗他已经被神来选中，说你要去帮我们灭掉这个世仇啊。
But now, Saul has been specially selected, for this task.To eliminate or to annihilate this, this perpetual enemy of the Israelites.
那他应该感觉到很荣幸。
So therefore, Saul should have felt that this was an honor for him.
那如果我们是扫罗的话，我们也知道说这个是很荣幸的一件事情。
And if we were Saul, we would know that this was an honorable task.
那应该好好的去听从神的命令，去完成他的这个使命啊。
And so therefore, we should have obeyed God and clearly.Heeded to his instructions.
那但是为什么会有这句话产生呢？
But how did this phrase happen, or when did it happen?
我们来看这撒母耳记的第十五章。
Let's turn to
撒母耳记上的第十五章。
First Samuel chapter 15.
撒母耳记上的第十五章的这个节是记载在22节。
This is recorded in verse 22. First Samuel chapter 15, verse 22. So Samuel said, "Has the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices, as in obeying the voice of the Lord. Behold, to obey is better than to sacrifice, and to heed than the fat of rams."
这边撒母耳呢跟扫罗说这样的一句话。
So Samuel actually said to Saul this phrase.
他讲的这句话就是。你说你这边有这么多祭牲了，要拿去献给神。
You say that there is now so much sacrifices that you want to, offer your burnt offerings to God.
不是神不喜欢人家献祭给他，神当然喜欢人家献祭给他。
It's not God that does not delight in these things.
但是在这个时刻呢
？But in this instance,
你把听从神的话语当作是，比献祭更不重要。
Because you have neglected the instructions of God, and you have put priority on these burnt offerings.
那为什么他会没有？那他到底做了什么事情没有听从神的话语呢
？So the question is again, what did Saul not do? Samuel says that he has disobeyed God.
在第二节这边到第三节这边
If you read the same chapter, verses 2 and 3,
那尤其第三节这边讲说，神就跟他讲，现在你要去击打亚玛利人，灭尽他们所有的，不可怜惜他们，将男女孩童吃奶的，并牛羊骆驼和驴尽心杀死。
So verse 3 particularly says, now go and attack Amalek and utterly destroy all that they have and do not spare them, but kill both man and woman, infant and nursing child, ox and sheep, camel and donkey.
所以神的命令很简单。
So the instructions of God was very simple and straightforward.
他没有跟他讲说你去攻击这国家的时候你要分 这些人不可以杀，这个人不可以杀，这个可以拿回来，这个不可以拿回来。
God did not sort of segregate, you know, who was to be killed or who was not to be killed, or what are the animals to bring back for sacrifices or otherwise.
这样的话就很辛苦嘛，哇，我们带一次手册，哎呀，这个杀人说，哎，这个有没有，是不是可以杀的啊，才来杀免。
Otherwise, they would have to bring along a handbook or a guideline, right, to check. To see if this person was to be eliminated.
神跟他讲，你进去里面就尽管杀，有看到人看到牲畜，全部跟他杀杀尽。
So verse 3 tells us that God told Saul to utterly destroy persons or any animal.
你不要看到那个还在喝奶的那个婴孩看到很可怜啊，神跟你讲杀，你就不用去想了。 就直接杀他,
So do not look at the infant or the nursing child and say, oh, this is so cute and death, but God says to annihilate all of them.
所以就是很简单的一个,就是很简单,去把它全部杀尽。
So God's instruction was very clear, that is to kill everyone.
但是为什么他还,那这么简单的一个命令呢? 那, 他好像是没有去服从啊。
But why then did Saul not obey all these instructions?
那他到底怎样没有服从? 如果我们看第九节的话,
let's read verse 9 where it's written where Saul had actually been disobedient.
那第九节讲说, 扫罗和百姓却联系亚甲, 也爱惜上好的牛羊, 牛犊, 羔羊, 并一切美物, 不敬, 不肯灭绝。
Verse 9 says that Saul and his people spared Agag and the best of the lamb, the sheep, the oxen, the fatlings, and the lambs, and all that was good.
那凡那些残的、那些贱的、瘦弱的那些，他觉得不美的，全部都已经杀尽。
And everything that Saul felt was not beautiful, everything that was despised and worthless, that they utterly destroyed.
那所以在这一节就看得出，他们当时没有完完全全的去听从神的这个吩咐。
So if you make a comparison of these verses, you can see that Saul actually did not fulfill all the instructions of God.
第一，他联系了那个亚甲王，亚甲就是当时的王。
And firstly, Saul actually spared the life of Agag, and Agag was the king at that time of Amalek.
我也真的不知道为什么他们要留下这个王的命啊。
Actually, I'm not sure why Saul actually spared the life of Agag, the king.
又不是亚甲，他还有别的国度，还有别的民，还可以跟他做个交换，或者有别的财物可以跟他做交换。
It's not that Agag had any more things left that was precious, or that he had other lands that they could actually do a trade, or that he could get from Agag.
对啊，所以他已经是个当时之人，他的国度都在我手上要灭亡了。 还可以什么可以跟我给我的呢?
And you can see that Agag was actually at the mercy of Saul, and there was nothing else left. So what else could he have given to Saul?
所以你去想想这些，这个扫罗跟那百姓到底在想什么?
And you will be wondering what Saul and his people, his soldiers, was thinking about at the time.
那他第二，他联系的那些上好的这些牛羊啊，这个我们可以了解哇，因为这是美物嘛。
And then the next thing that he spared was the best of the sheep, the oxen, etc. And this we understand why. Probably Saul spared the animal's life.
因为它是美的,
because they were beautiful, they were good, they were worthy.
所以他们这样去做, 当然我们一般人也可以理解了,
And when Saul did that, of course us, you and I, would understand why perhaps Saul would have done that.
但是他这样的去行, 却是违背了神的诫命。
But by sparing the lives of these animals, Saul was actually disobeying the simple instructions of God.
可是他却说他有一个很好的一个原因，那个理由为什么他要这么去做？
But Saul said to everyone that he had this very good reason why he had spared the lives of these animals.
他说他从你看从13到15节这里讲啊。
Let's read from verse 13 to verse 15 where he says.
这边13节，撒母耳到扫罗那里，扫罗对他说：“耶和华赐福于你，耶和华的命令我已经遵守了。” 撒母耳说：“我耳中听见有羊，还有牛，牛鸣，是从哪里来的呢？”15节，扫罗说：“这是百姓从亚玛利人那里带来的，因为我爱惜上好的牛羊，要献与耶和华你的神。”其余的我都灭尽了。好，你看这边。 当扫母来到他的面前
，So when Samuel came before the face of Saul，
那他就看到了，哎，为什么有牛羊的声音啊
？How come Samuel says, how come I hear the sound of the bleating of the lambs？
哎，扫罗讲，哎呀，你不知道，这些是好好东西呀、
啊。Says, oh, you do not know, because these are all the good and worthy stuff。
那这些好东西，现在我要来献给你的神。
Now this best of the sheep and oxen, I want to take to sacrifice to your God.
哎，当然他也是他的神呐、啊，可是
他讲到这样 of course, it's his God.
他特别跟他讲，你敬拜这个神，我特别要给他、哦。
It's just that he wanted to emphasize to Samuel, hey, this is your God. I want to offer these best things to your God.
哇，这时候这样的一个好的理由，是否真的好的理由呢
？So now the question is, this very good.Reason, that was given by Saul, was it truly a good reason?
那我们去想一下，应该是好的，因为他是要献给神，他有没有讲说我要留给自己
？And to think about it, you may consider and say, huh, okay, maybe this is true. He is not keeping these animals for himself, but he is taking these good and beautiful animals to be offered as a sacrifice to God.
除非他是有他有藏了一些私货啊，然后留在后面，那些更好的留在后面没有献给神呢、
啊。Of course, you can say, oh, privately he may have kept some of the best for himself somewhere else.
但是你发觉他却不是这样，他真的把全部都已经拿给神了。
But you must understand that Saul did not do that. He actually took everything, that he did not kill.And was prepared to offer this to God.
那如果他是有私藏一些货物，当然神一定会生气啊，大家也会觉得生气嘛。你说拿最好的，你还私藏最好的给自己。
Of course, if he had privately stored away some of the best, animals, then that would not be right on the part of Saul. But now he had actually given everything.
那但是他跟撒母耳却不是这样来看待这件事情。
But If you look at from the perspective of Samuel, this was not what Samuel saw.
Samuel 看见的是他的不忠诚。
Samuel saw Saul's unfaithfulness.
即便你们旁边的人可能看到扫罗好像有表达他的虔诚。
For people at that point in time, when they were beside Saul, they would have said, "Huh, this is the sincerity of Saul."
他的敬拜神的那种的敬虔。
And that you can see.The faithfulness, the sincerity in wanting to offer this sacrifice to God.
在打仗做到这么辛苦，在打仗的话，命都要给人家杀了，他还想到说，我等一下留一些好的来敬拜神呢。
And to think that, oh, you know, you spend so much effort and at the risk of losing your life, yet, you know, you have thought to put aside animals to be a sacrifice to God.
那这个不是好像在敬拜神的一个虔诚的一个动作吗？
Isn't this a very sincere and faithful thing that you would have done if you were want to worship God properly?
那但是你发觉撒母耳却没有说他你这个虔诚是假的或者你不是真的要敬拜神的。
But you discover that Saul did not say, Samuel did not say these things that you know, that Saul had put aside and was good for him to put aside all these animals.
就应该讲说扫母耳没有说啊好对你是假的你不是在虔诚、啊、他没有这样来讲他。
Samuel did not criticize Saul for his so-called sincerity. You did not say that, oh, you are fake, alright?、Samuel did not say that to Saul.
可是他有更大的一个问题。
But the bigger question, the bigger problem was this.
就是他没有忠心。
That,
没有遵守神的诫命。
That Saul had not obeyed fully the instructions of God.
所以你发觉刚才在那边，刚才十五节撒母耳就这样来责备他了。
And so therefore, verse 15 you can see, and verse 16 you can see how Samuel had rebuked Saul.
那讲说，你没有听从神的话语。
That you have not actually obeyed the instructions of God.
那这句话扫罗他讲的时候其实是谁告诉他的这件事情就是撒母耳对不起撒母耳所说的这句话你没有听从神的话语是谁跟他讲的呢
And you might wonder, who actually told Samuel that Saul did not obey God?
那其实是神自己本身这么说的。
Then you realize that it's actually God himself who had told Samuel directly.
因为你看第十一节。
Let's read verse 11.
那天晚上神的话临到撒母耳了。
That day, in verse 10 says, the word of the Lord came to Samuel.
他就跟撒母耳讲说我立扫罗为王我后悔了。
Verse 11 says, I greatly regret that I set up Saul as king.
因为他转去不跟从我不遵守我的命令。
For he has turned back from following me. and has not performed my commandments.
所以你发觉撒母耳还没有来到这地方验证这整件事情，神早就跟他讲，哎呀，这个家伙已经不听我的话。
You can see that even before Samuel stepped into anywhere near Saul, God had already informed Samuel that this person had not obeyed his commandments.
所以你才发觉，他虽然扫罗跟他辩解说，我其实做的这些都是为了神的时候，撒母耳他根本没有动心啊。
So you can see how the pleading of Saul about how he was sincere in preparing all these animals as sacrifice did not move the heart of Samuel.
因为神已经这样宣判，他不听从我的话。
Because God had already judged that Saul was someone who did not perform God's commandments.
那这个就是扫罗他当时，所以神也是在这边也是很懊恼，也是很后悔，他讲说后悔立他为王了。
So therefore, God says that he had greatly regretted that he had put Saul as king.
这个不听从神的话，或者 不是个完完全全遵守神的话的这件事情，遵守神的命令这件事情，真的是一个很懊恼的一件事情啊。
So this was something very regretful, for all the, for everyone, at that point.
什么叫做完全听从神呢？
What does it mean by to fully perform according to his commandment?
其实你看扫罗他有听从神呢。
You can say that Saul.Did obey God's commandments.
因为他有去下道去攻打这个亚玛利人。
Because he had gone to this place to annihilate the Amalekites.
对，他也有去杀掉那些人。
And he did kill the people that were Amalekites.
但所以你这样讲的话，他某个程度上有遵从神的话语。
So to a certain degree, you can say that Saul had obeyed God.
那现在他做的不完全，你就跟他讲，你就剩下这些全部杀完他就算了嘛。
Then all you need to say to Saul is, hey, for the rest, the balance that wasn't killed, please kill it now.
就直接这边责备他，哎，你真的没有做美啊，这个东西做了留守尾，跟他做完他现在哦。
You left behind some little things that you did not finish. Please complete.And finish your task that has been given to you.
不要把这么大的罪名说不听从我的话这句话安在他身上嘛，人都会有软弱的嘛，不是吗？
Yeah, perhaps you may empathize with the weakness, his weakness, and say, hey, do not say that he had not obeyed God the instructions.
但是神这宣判是神自己判的。
But this judgment came from God Himself.
神自己知道说扫罗他根本不会听从他的话。
God knew that Saul did not and will not obey his commandments.
因为这是第二次了嘛。
Because this is now the second time.
第一次他也是为了自己，他也是去献祭啊。那这一次，他又来为了自己，要留下这些好的。
The first time was when Saul actually was impatient and he actually went forward to offer sacrifices even though he was not the priest.
所以神了解他，他是个不听从我话的人。
So God understood.Saul and knew that he was someone who would not perform his commandments.
那你跟他拿他跟亚伯拉罕来对比的话，
Now if you make him as a comparison to this other man Abraham,
那亚伯拉罕他被神吩咐说，你带你的孩子上到摩利亚山去那边献了他。
Abraham was tasked and given instructions to take his only son to the top of Mount Moriah and offer him as a sacrifice.
那亚伯拉罕他是怎么样听从神的话呢？
And how did Abraham obey the instructions of God?
我们知道说他隔天就立刻带他儿子上到摩利亚山去献祭。
We read in the scriptures how the very next day after this instruction was given that Abraham took his son Isaac to Mount Moriah.
而且他走了三天，又有三天的时间在那边给他有机会反悔，可是他却没有。
And then there was a 3 days journey that Abraham could actually turn around and say no, he will not do it, but he did not.
他一直到最后的时候要拿刀要杀他的时候，他都坚决要完成神的命令。
And even at the point of taking the knife to cut his son, yet he continued. He persisted.
这个就是亚伯拉罕听从神的话，立刻去行，而且行到底。
This is the sort of Abraham's obedience to the instructions of God, right to the very small detail and.Up to the very end.
那如果我们是亚伯拉罕的话
，If we were Abraham,
我们可能会说，好了，我可以献，可是不一定现在献，因为神没有给个期限嘛。
We may tell ourselves, yes, I will sacrifice, but maybe, not immediately, because God did not give me the timing, the period of time.
我就等我的 以撒长大了，生了孩子，我有孙子了之后，再拿他去献呢。
Perhaps you may give the excuse that, hey, let me wait until Isaac has grown up, got married, has children. Then at least I have some generations after me. Then maybe I can take Isaac to be offered as a sacrifice.
对，照样是听从神的话，他只叫我献而已嘛，没有说叫我献年轻的，他叫我献他，献老的也是可以的。
We can offer the older Isaac instead of the younger version of him.
那这个也是听从神的话，不是吗？某个层次上也是听从神的话。
You give yourself the excuse, yes.You see, I'm also still obeying God.
但是你知道，只是当时神就是要试验他的信心。
But this was the time when Abraham was tested in his faith by God.
就是你现在唯一的孩子，你没有什么孙子啊，你唯一的孩子哦，你愿不愿意献上嘛？
This is your only child. Now I want you to be of, I want him to be offered as a sacrifice.
所以他就听从神的话，就把他去献了。
So you can see that Abraham actually obeyed immediately.Took action and went forward to offer him as a sacrifice.
那这个就是真正的顺服神，听从神啊。
So you can see the difference if you make a comparison between Abraham who fully obeyed the instructions of God versus Saul.
那我们呢？我们是怎么样的呢？我们怎么样顺服神的呢？
How about us? How do we obey the instructions of God?
我们会像扫罗一样做事情。对啦，我有在做啊，可是没有做好啦。反正我有软弱嘛，神也可以原谅我。
Are we like Saul and we give the excuse that, hey, you know, we are still weak. We did obey the instructions of God, but you know, maybe not fully.
如果我不信神的话，如果我不想去顺服神，我早就完全不要去守他了嘛。
If I really don't believe in God, then of course I won't even follow His instructions at all.
因为我软弱，所以我就服从一半啦。不要说没有了，一半也可以了。
Because I'm weak in my flesh, and therefore I obey half lah. Keep half of the instructions.
那你觉得你这样去做，这样好像很灵巧，或者很有理由去做这样的一种服从的话，你觉得神会喜悦吗？
You think that you are wise in your own ways? Do you think God is happy or pleased with what you're doing?
那如果我们看扫罗的例子，就知道神不喜悦了。
So if you look at the example of Saul, you know that God was displeased with Saul.
你看扫罗他用什么方式来跟神来这样讲
？And you can see what kind of exchange Saul had with God.
他说我用敬拜神的方式来换你的不听从，懂吗？来换我的不听从。
I use my worship, you know, this worship of the sacrifice, to replace, you know, that sort of full obedience.
那敬拜是好的，是敬拜是好的。
Worship is good, isn't it?
那你应该接受我的这种的敬拜。
You should accept my this worship, this sacrifice from me.
但是神他不是要你的敬拜。
But God does not just want your sacrifice.
你的这种他需要你敬拜，可是他需要你更顺从，完完全全听从他。
God wants your sacrifice, but also wants you to be fully understanding in obeying the instructions of God.
那这个就是神他要训练我们每一个人的。
So this is a training. This is the test that God wants us to put through.
所以耶稣基督当他降生为人的时候
，So when Jesus was born as a man on earth,
他也是面对同一样的训练。
And therefore he received the same type of training.
那他到死的那一刻，差不多 要死的那时候，在祷告，在哥西马尼园祷告。
At his point near death, when he was praying in the Garden of Gethsemane,
我们都知道说他当时候有一点要挣扎，他想说，如果可以的话，就不要去了。
We read in the scriptures how he did struggle, and he said that if it's possible, take this cup away from me.
那但他还在那边流泪哭泣，在那边祈求神呢。
And he was crying bitterly towards God.
那就好像我们怎么样，有些时候流泪哭泣，希望神可以听我们祷告。
So sometimes it's likened to us, where we actually weep bitterly before God, asking God to hear our prayers.
那耶稣基督也做类似我们这样的一些祷告。
So Jesus also actually showed us the example of how he would have done it by weeping bitterly towards God.
但是他最终怎么样？他还是一样顺服神。
But finally, you can see how he accepted the will of God, to be nailed on the cross.
一直到死的那个刹那，他都顺服到底啊。
And he accepted this will, the instructions or the commandment of God up to the point of death.
那这个就是我们基督徒要让自己变成的一个榜样，或变成的一个样式。
So this becomes very clearly an example for all of us Christians as we grow in our faith.
那当然，这个不是一朝一夕的工作。
This is not something that we can do immediately, but over a period of time.
对，神他会帮助我们，因为神他也赐给我们圣灵，让我们慢慢的去学习。
Because God has given us the sweet Holy Spirit that allows us to transform ourselves and grow in that faith towards God.
只要我们顺服他，我们了解他是我们的主宰，他是我们必定要听从的人，那我们就可以慢慢的去做得到。
And as long as we heed and understand that Jesus is our ultimate Lord, we will be able to slowly take on these instructions for ourselves.
好，那为什么扫罗，他不可以办得到，他没办法办到这一点呢？他在这时刻到底发生什么事？
Now, let's ask ourselves, why was Saul unable to fulfill this commandment?
我们看第十五章的第十二节。
Let's read chapter 15, verse 12 in 1 Samuel. Verse 12, so when Samuel rose early in the morning to meet Saul, it was told Samuel saying, Saul went to Carmel, indeed he set up a monument for himself and has gone on around, passed by and gone down on to Gilgal.
好，十二节，扫罗，撒母耳因为听见神的话，他就要去找扫罗了。
So Samuel, verse 12 tells us that he rose to try to meet Saul because of the from the voice of God.
那这时候的扫罗呢，他其实已经到过了加密这个地方。
You can see from here that he Saul had been to Carmel.
那这个加密是犹大的加密，不是我们以利亚祷告的那个加密山了。
This is not the Mount Carmel of Elijah, but this is the Carmel in Judah.
所以他走去加密，这个就比较靠近可能菲利斯那边的那个地方。
So this is nearer to where they were, this Carmel.
那他在那边做了一件事情。
And then he actually had already done something.
他立了一个纪念碑。
He set up a monument for himself.
中文没有讲说为他自己立个纪念碑，可是应该是为了自己立了一个纪念碑。
In Chinese, it's not so clear, but in English, it says that he built a monument for himself.
因为你讲说立纪念碑的话，也可以纪念神，让我有这样的一个这样是一个圣战哦，感谢神一个纪念碑嘛。
Because when you build a monument, you can say, "Oh, thank God for this victory over in the battle, and this monument is built for this purpose."
但是这边不是讲，是为了他自己立了一个纪念碑。
That here it says that he set up a monument for himself.
那因为什么？刚才讲说，因为这个是他的仕敌啊，他现在有这个荣耀，这个荣誉在那边把这个仕敌给杀掉嘛。
Because he had now come to the conclusion that you know this was the glory that he had killed most of the Amalekites, the arch enemy of the Israelites.
以色列人的仕敌，我杀了他，哇，我是伟大人物吗？
所以 he had now killed all the this arch enemy of the Israelites, this Amalekite, and therefore he considered himself a hero.
所以他立了一个纪念碑给大家看，就是我。
He built he set up a monument for himself to show others that what he has done.
所以你这时候就可以看到他的想法是什么。
So you can see his thoughts behind this.
他听从神的话去灭他，如果你是真正敬拜神的话，他就是神的话也叫我去灭，有什么特别的？
So if you truly obey God, you will just say, okay, I'm just obeying God, and these are the actions I'm doing. What's that to shout about?
今天是我，可能改次是另外一个人去做另外一件事情嘛。
Today is just me, tomorrow it could be someone else that God has appointed to carry out his task.
我们应该大家感谢神有给我一个机会来灭掉以色列的势力啊。
And we should just thank God, all of us, you and me, so that, you know, that we have this chance to annihilate the enemies.
但是他却自己觉得这是我的能力啊。这是我办的，我办到的一件事情。
But perhaps Saul was so confident of himself that he felt that this was his ability to kill off his arch enemy of the Israelites.
他也忘记了，他这么顺利可以灭掉他，也是神给他这个胜利啊。
And that he had forgotten that it was God who had given him this victory.
所以这时候你可以看到他已经有点抬高自己的一个表现。
So you can say number one that Saul had actually elevated himself.A little bit in this example.
那是否真正的是这样？你再继续看的话，就真的是如此。
Then you question yourself, is he really like that? But if you read on, you find that he is really like that.
那如果看第十七节，撒母耳怎么去讲他的
？Verse 17, you see how Samuel rebuked him.
撒母耳对扫罗说：“从前你虽然自以为小，岂不是被立为以色列支派的元首吗
？”He says, Samuel said, when you were little in your own eyes.Were you not head of the tribes of Israel?
你看，扫罗都跟他讲，你以前你自己都觉得你是小，就是谦卑的一个人哦。
In the past, you were such a humble person. You felt that you were little in the eyes. in your own eyes.
你自己都知道，大家也知道，可是神却立你做王呢。
But yet, when you were humble, God actually anointed you as king.
现在你呢？你就不是这么小了，是吗？
And、
你不觉得自己以为小了吗？
And now you think that you are no longer that small small person or that humble person.
所以你现在你竟然为了这件事情擅自做主，不听从神的话语。
And that now you had the not utterly destroyed the sinners, the Amalekites, and therefore
擅自做主，自己做
主。You have made those decisions to spare some of them, and this decision was yours.
那这个就代表你的骄傲，你觉得你才是这个整个国家的元首，不是神了。
And therefore, you have considered yourself to be the leader of the whole people of Israel, and you have taken these instructions upon yourself. And these were instructions not given by God.
所以呢，他你可以看到他的骄傲的心啊。
So you can see this arrogant heart of Saul.
那被责备完了之后的扫罗。
And after Saul was rebuked.
24节。
Verse 24.
到25节，这边讲说扫罗。
Verse 24 and 25.
扫罗对撒母耳说：“我有罪了。”
Saul said to Samuel, "I have sinned. I've transgressed."
看起来他终于承认自己。对，我是有错误了，没有听从神的话。
It seems that Samuel seems to have regretted, Saul regretted what he had done, he has sinned.
但是他第二句话讲说，因为我惧怕百姓。
And then verse 24, he gave the excuse again. Oh, the background of this is because I feared the people.
所以我听他的话，所以我才会违背神的话。
And therefore I obeyed their voice, and therefore I disobeyed the voice of God.
他当时候都是王了，他不，如果他真的觉得他真的是会怕百姓，他还自己立一个纪念碑，根本都是不是真的是百姓的问题嘛。
So therefore, you can see that truly this was not the voice of the people. If not, why would Saul would have gone to build a foundation or a monument for himself?
也有可能是神百姓，可是百姓他是王，他可以直接不要去否定他们的话语嘛。
And perhaps it was the voice of the people who asked for these things. But if you are the king, you would have the overriding factor.
他讲完这句话，你看二十五节。
And therefore, after he finished, he read verse 25.
他说二十五节，现在求你怜悯我，求你赦免我的罪，同我回去，我好敬拜耶和华。
Please pardon my sin and return with me so that I may worship the Lord.
哇，看起来他真的悔改，说那你跟我一起回去，我没去敬拜神了，可能说求神怜悯我，求神赦免我这样。
So it seems from this verse that Saul actually repented from what he had. Saul repented from what he had done, and now he wanted to go back and worship God, and therefore please forgive him.
但是我们知道说过后呢，扫罗就跟他讲，我不会跟你回去的。
And then, if you read on, you find that Samuel did not want to go back with him.
26节，因为你厌弃耶和华的命令，耶和华也厌弃你。
And,
做以色列的王。
And Samuel said to Saul, I will not return with you, for you've rejected the word of the Lord, and the Lord has also rejected you.
那过后就发生了，他扯坏他扯了他衣服，那扫罗怎么去责备他？
And how later on, how Saul sees the edge of the robe and tore, and how Samuel rebuked him.
那在30节这边。
If you read verse 30 now,
那扫罗他再一次的做最后的一个挣扎。
And therefore, you see Saul actually struggling the last time.
他说我有罪了。
Says I've sinned.
对啊，虽然如此哦。
So even so,
就是我有罪了，可是只是虽然是如此。
I've sinned, but yet, you know, or even so.
求你在我百姓的长老和以色列人面前抬举我，同我回去。
Please.Honor me by going back with me to return to the elders of the people and before Israel.
那现在呢？好敬拜耶和华你的神啊，不是我的神了。
And then return with me that I may worship the Lord your God, no longer my God.
因为二十五节这边讲说，恐我回去敬拜耶和华嘛，是好像是我们的神啊，我要去敬拜耶和华。
Verse 25 in reference, Saul said, that we may go back and worship the Lord. Now he's saying your Lord.
所以他把神都好像这是你的神啊，不是我的神了。
So it seems that Saul had actually returned God to Samuel.
那既然神是你的，那现在为什么要跟我回去呢？
Now it seems
神都是撒母耳的嘛。
And the God is Samuel's. Why do I need to then return?
你要回来，因为我的面子啊，放不下。
Because my face is at stake, my reputation is at stake. If you don't come with me.
你在众人面前讲到我这样，我的国度会被人家拿去哦，我已经被神厌弃哦。
You say all these things about how the Lord has rebuked me and that my kingdom was taken away before my people. Where am I going to have my reputation?
你现在又跑掉的话，那我根本不用去做王了，我还要怎么做王？
And now you as Prophet Samuel, you are going away. You're not standing with me. How can I now become the king of Israel?
所以帮忙我一下，让我有面子啊，可以在百姓面前再立足啊。
So please, you know, come with me so that I can have the face.To meet my people.
所以你看这两次回应他说我有罪我有罪。
So even though twice Saul said that he had sinned before God.
但是他真的感觉到他有罪吗？
But when you read this passage, do you feel that Saul felt that he had sinned?
他知道他有罪，他知
道。He knew that he had sinned.
他也知道说现在后果是什么。
Yes, he knew that this was the consequences of his sin.
但是他的脸比这个罪更重要， but, 比得罪神更重要。
But to Saul, his face, his reputation was more important than this sin that he had committed.
所以你就可以看得出，这时候扫罗已经是有那种的骄傲的存在。
So we can read from here now that really Saul had this arrogance in him.
怪不得扫罗讲，你小的时候，你那时候啊，从前你是自己以为是小的，现在你却变成这样。
That's why you can read verse 17, right? That Samuel says, when you were little in your own eyes, that time you were like that, but now you're different.
他当时候自己都感觉到是谦卑的啊，所以他真的是谦卑的一个人来的。
And that time Saul felt that he was humble, and therefore he was truly humble at that time.
但是现在却改变了。
But now he was totally changed.
所以这个就是为什么他不愿意去听从神的诫命。
And therefore,You can say that is the reason why Saul did not completely heed the instructions of God.
因为他已经高于过神了。
Because he felt that he was greater than God himself.
那我们今天，我们身为基督徒的，我们是不是这样的一个基督徒呢？
So as Christians, are we also Christians like Saul?
我们是不是一个谦卑的一个基督徒呢？
Are we Christians that are humble?And feel little in our own eyes.
我们会不会有些时候高于过神的呢？
Or do we exceed ourselves and actually feel that we are greater than God?
啊，你可能感觉到，你不感觉到啊，可能你自己本身没有感觉到。
Perhaps you may not have felt this personally, but others may have felt it.
对，可能旁边的人就已经感觉到，也有提醒过你了。
And others around you may have reminded you that way.
但是你却觉得没有啊，我在为神做事情啊，你还跟自己讲我在为神做事情啊。
And then yet you tell yourself, no, no, I'm not like that. I'm still serving God properly.
你看其他人有没有人在做？不是我在做吗？
You look at others. Do they do it? Even I am doing it when others are not doing.
就是因为我需要做，所以我才会有这样比较极端的表现。
And because I have to do it, therefore I have such kind of extreme behavior as you can see.
不是骄傲，这是我对神的那种的那种。急迫感，想要为神的服务的那种急迫感。
This is my zealousness and fervency towards God. Don't see it as pride.
但是呢，是否是如此？当然，大家心里面都知道的啦。
But whatever is the situation, everyone around him knows.
所以呢，有些时候我们每个人真的要去审问自己，我现在是否是到了这个程度？
So therefore, most times we have to examine ourselves. Have we reached a stage like Saul?
你看扫罗他。没有察觉到自己是这样的，他自己立一个纪念碑啊，还自己跑去立一个纪念碑。你看
，You see how Saul didn't even realize he had built himself a monument to honor this victory.
当然，你讲说就是因为神召他做王，如果他不做王的话，他哪里可能会变成这样
？Then you can say, oh, actually, it was God who actually anointed Saul as king. If he was not anointed, then he wouldn't be like that.
所以这个问题现在是神了。
So now you point the problem at God.
但是神在那时候就讲，扫罗讲，当时我叫你来的时候，你是谦卑的，我又没有在你骄傲的时候叫你。
Yeah, like Samuel said, when you were then a little in your own eyes, we anointed you.
如果当时你是骄傲，神怎么可能会叫你做王
？If you were arrogant at the time, how did God even find you to anoint you as king?
所以不要把问题丢给神，是你自己不警醒，你自己变走了样，然后变成骄傲了。
So do not point the finger at God and.Because you yourself have actually strayed from the good path, and therefore you are now very arrogant.
而且已经有一次过一次警戒了。
And previously there was already one earlier warning.
对，可是你现在变本加厉，完全不要去听神的话。
But now it seems that you have completely ignored and disobeyed the commandments of God.
所以这个就是一个骄傲的人，他会走向的一个灭亡的这种方向。
So you can say that this is the path of destruction.Of someone who had changed from humility to arrogance.
哎，那这个真的是我们每个人要去提醒自己的。
So please, remind ourselves of this incident.
哎，时常要祷告，让神来检查我们的心啊。
And when we pray, let us examine our own hearts.
哎，让神帮我们可以把那个骄傲的那种心态完全的除去。
That God remove this heart of pride, this heart of arrogance from within all of us.
让我们可以真正的好像基督一样。
Just like we, so that we can all be Christ-like.
我们一起唱诗歌244首。
Let's now sing hymn 244.